Hello and welcome to part 3 of my syringe engine build. To join the motor to the rest of the mechanism, I needed a drive wheel. I had new aluminium and brass in stock, but that wasn't really in the spirit of the project, and as my missing piece of door handle from part 1 still hadn't turned up, I had to use something else. I can't remember what this lump of aluminium used to be, but it went in the junk drawer because I knew one day it would come in handy. I cut a square off with the bandsaw, then took it over to the mill. With the good edge up against the fixed jaw and the rough edge packed with a piece of soft wire, I cleaned off the black anodized top surface to make marking out easier. Finding the centre, I drew a circle and then drilled and reamed a 3mm hole ready to take the spindle of the motor. Using a scrap of 3mm silver steel as an axle, I roughly indexed the work by hand to take off the bulk of the excess material. Next, I prepared another click spring superglue arbor. Given that the first cuts on the lathe might be intermittent, I wanted to strengthen the setup a bit. So the center of the arbor was drilled and tapped M3, and then the first 10mm or so were reamed to take an alignment pin. The wheel was fitted, and once the glue had just started to go off, I secured it with a screw. In hindsight, the screw probably wasn't necessary. There you live and learn. I tidied up the diameter, then swapped tools and cut a reduced section on the end. The wheel and arbor were taken to the mill to drill and tap, ready for a grub screw. After some warmth from the blow lamp, the parts were separated. Then it was back to the lathe to take off some of the spare thickness. Lastly, I made a hole to take a drive pin. The drive needed to be adjustable so the swing of the oscillating pressure could be set. I'd do this with an intermediate drive arm. The material for this came from a scrap bullnose gas cylinder nut. After sawing a piece off, it was brought to shape on the mill. The centre of the narrow edge was drilled and tapped M2. Two holes were drilled and reamed in the top face to take pins for the drive wheel and the conrod. Just to make it look nice, I wasted the sides a little bit. To round off the ends, I made another set of filing buttons, one for the end and two for the edge, held in place by small cap head screws. The belt sander made light work of this, followed by some finishing on wet and dry. A slitting saw was used to form a clamp, and then the threads from the top half were removed using the pillar drill. The arm sweeps an arc over the surface of the drive wheel, allowing the syringe stroke to be adjusted right down to zero. Join me in part 4 when I'll be making some securing posts, a base plate, and finally putting everything together.